three linear equations in three variables using matrix inversion method as well as Cramer's method. In the last class, in 43, 44, 45, we discussed about solving two linear equations in two variables using different methods like inversion method, elimination method, and all we discussed, okay, in the previous classes. And now in this class, we are going to solve three equations in three variables using matrix inversion method and Cramer's method, okay. Just have a look at this. First of all, to solve these equations using matrix inversion method, we need to convert them into matrix form. See, first we need to convert the given equations into matrix form, and then first we go by matrix inversion method and by Cramer's method. This is the algebraic form of the given equations, and you wish to convert them into matrix form. You may write like this: matrix x plus y plus z, 2x plus 3y plus 4z, and x plus 2y minus j is the left side matrix, which is equals to the right side one, 6, 22. Okay. And after that, we need to write this left side matrix as a product of coefficient matrix and the variable matrix as we discussed in the previous case. So this implies this matrix x plus y plus z, 2x plus 3y plus 4z, and x plus 2y minus z can be expressed like this: product of 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, minus 1. This is a 3 by 3 matrix, and we need to multiply it with x, y, z. It results as 6, 22. Is that right? Just have a look. This is a matrix of order 3 by 3, and this is a matrix of order 3 by 1. Okay, if you multiply these two, you will get this 3 by 1 matrix. So the product of these two is equals to this given matrix, and that's why we are rewriting it like this. And after that, we will just take this as a coefficient matrix, and this as capital X, we call it as variable matrix, and this 622 we represent it by B, and we call it as what? Constant matrix. Once again, I am repeating: coefficient matrix, variable matrix, constant matrix. So from this we need to find variable matrix x, y, z, since we are solving first by matrix inversion method, and this is the way. Okay, so this implies ax is equals to b I have. Since ax is equals to b, our intention is to find small x, y, and z. That in the sense, we need to find this variable matrix x, y, z. And for that, you just apply A inverse on both sides. A inverse of Ax is equals to A inverse of B. And in the left side, A inverse into A, because matrices have associative property. So A inverse A into X is equals to A inverse B. And A inverse A, by inverse property, any inverse of a matrix when multiplied with the given matrix is I. So this is identity. Ix is equals to A inverse B. Ix, identity when multiplied with X gives us X itself, and that X is equals to A inverse B. And we know that A inverse is nothing but 1 by that A into adjoint of A into B. So at the end, that X is equals to 1 by that A into adjoint A into B. And now, to find that variable matrix X, we need to use this as a formula. So we have matrix A, find determinant of A, and then write adjoint of A, we need to multiply with B. Okay, the process may be a bit lengthy, but we need to follow, right? So first of all, you need to find determinant of A, then try to form adjoint of A, okay, and then multiply that adjoint of A with B, you will get that variable matrix X, right? Just have a look. So at the end, we have A is equals to coefficient matrix 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, minus 1. And a rule related to X to find X is equals to 1 by dt A into adjoint of B. So we need to find solve the equations small x, small y, small z we need to find. For that we need to find this variable matrix x. So this is the formula. So first find the determinant of A, then find adjoint of A, and then multiply these three. That's our plan. So finding determinant of A, so we are very familiar. So finding determinant of A is simply nothing but 1 into these four elements minus 1 into these four elements plus 1 into the remaining four elements. And on simplification, see, with the usual process of finding determinant, you will get the determinant of A is equals to minus 4. Okay, just for the space concern, I am erasing all this. Okay, so determinant of A, we have it as minus 4. And then we need to write adjoint of A. See, adjoint of A is simply nothing but the transpose of the cofactor matrix. And that's why, see, now adjoint of A is the transpose of the cofactor matrix. You just write cofactor matrix and then take transpose, okay? First, suppose if you are trying to construct a cofactor matrix here, you just take its transpose, it gives us adjoint matrix. And to construct that cofactor matrix, so we know that first of all we need to take alternate symbols plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. The symbols part is clear. And the next part, we need to take the determinant of the remaining four elements by leaving the corresponding row and column as per the position. So for suppose you are thinking for this one, see, leave this row and this column, take the remaining four elements. So here you need to take determinant of 3, 2, 4, minus 1. That is that position. When you come for the next element is this position, leave that row and column, the remaining four elements. So the determinant of 2, 1, 4, minus 1. Just look here, the remaining four elements. Whereas coming for this last one, yeah, see, this row and this column you need to leave. And pay attention on the remaining four elements, which are 2, 1 and 3, 2. So this is the determinant of 2, 1, 3, 2. Okay. Likewise, we need to consider the determinants for every element. Okay. For this element, leave this row and this column, remaining four elements. You have 1, 1, 2, minus 1. Okay. Next element, 3. Leave that row and column, remaining elements, 1, 1, 1, 1, minus 1. So 1, 1, 1, minus 1. Already we constructed the adjoint matrix in this way for different problems in previous classes also. Okay. Whereas coming for the last element, 4, you just leave that row and leave that column. Think about the remaining four elements, which are 1, 1, 1, 2. By leaving the corresponding row of the 4 and the column, this position. Okay. And that's why 1, 1, 1, 2. So here it is the determinant of 1, 1, 1, 2. And next, this position. This position means this element. Leave that row, leave that column, pay attention on the remaining four elements, which are 1, 1, 3, 4. Okay? And next, this position. This position means corresponding element is this. So leave that row and leave that column. Think about the remaining four elements, which are 1, 2, 1, 4. Okay? And then the last row. See, this is the last element. Leave that row, leave that column, the remaining four elements, which are 1, 1, 2, 3. Okay, just have a look. If I did any mistake in there, just have a look. Okay, and adjoint of A is simply nothing but the transpose of this matrix. So adjoint of A at the end is equals to the matrix. See, direct I will write the transpose. Okay, first of all, what is this element? Minus 3 minus 8 is minus 11. So outside plus is there, so this element is minus 11. Okay. Next, what you say about this element? When you come for this element, the determinant is minus 2 minus 4 is minus 6, and outside minus is there, it is plus 6. Actually, I need to write plus 6 here, but directly I am taking the transpose, so I will write plus 6 here. Then coming for this element, 4 minus 3 is 1, so this is 1. So first row is clear, for transpose I wrote first column. And this element, minus 1 minus 2 is minus 3, outside minus is there, so this is 3. Then minus 1 minus 1 minus 2, so this is minus 2. Then 2 minus 1 is 1 with a minus sign minus 1. Then this element again 4 minus 3 is 1. And here 4 minus 2 is 2 and outside minus is there minus 2. And then 3 minus 2 is 1. Just add them. This is a joint of A. So our intention is to find the variable matrix X. To find that variable matrix X, we need 1 by determinant of A and adjoint A. So we found determinant of A as minus 4, adjoint A as this. And after that, to find this X, we need to multiply this adjoint A with B along with what 1 by det A. Okay, before going to that, just have a look about this way of writing adjoint matrix. And just have a look. So look at the board. We have determinant of A and adjoint A, and we are going to find X. So as per the rule, X is simply nothing but 1 by det A into adjoint A into B, right? So you just replace determinant of A with minus 4, adjoint A with the matrix, and B with the constant matrix 622. So we need to multiply these two and then apply that 1 by minus 4. Multiply with this 1 by minus 4. After that, we will get the values of X. Okay, so for that you just look here. This is equals to 1 by minus 4 into multiplication of these two matrices is simply nothing but first row with this column. So minus 11 into 6, directly I am writing minus 66 plus this 3 into 20 is plus 60 plus 1 into 2 is plus 2. Okay, next one, 6 into 6 is 36, and then minus 2 into 20, minus 40, and after that, minus 2 into minus 2 is minus 4. The next one, 1 into 6 is 6, 1 into 20 plus 20, and then 1 into 2 is 2. Okay, so just have a look at that. So we need to simplify all this thing. Okay, this is equals to minus 66 plus 60 plus 2. Okay, how can we get it? This is simply 62 minus 66 plus 62. Outside we have that 1 by minus 4, right? Minus 1 by 4 times this is minus 4, and here it is 36 minus 44. 36 minus 44 is simply nothing but minus 8. Okay, right? And then what it is, 20 plus 6, 26 plus 2 is 28. This is 28. Okay, minus 1 by 4, minus 4, minus 8 and 28. If you multiply every element with that minus 1 by 4, it gives us minus 1 by 4 into 1 by minus 1 by 4 is 1, minus 8 into this minus 1 by 4 is 2, and then minus 1 by 4 into this 28 is minus 7. So at the end, this is the variable matrix X with 1, 2, minus 7. Okay, so see, variable matrix means what actually? Actually, variable matrix is nothing but the matrix having the variables X, Y, Z. If you compare these two, your value of X is equals to 1, your value of Y is equals to 2, and the value of Z is minus 7. And we need to check whether it is right or wrong just by taking these values in the given equation. Okay, so replace X with 1, Y with 2, Z with minus 7. So for sure it is not satisfied. So somewhere we did a mistake actually. Chepo. So then if you multiply this third row with this third column, 1 into 6 is 6, minus 1 into 20 is minus 20, and 1 into 2 is plus 2. And we need to simplify. So this is equals to minus 1 by 4, and this is minus 4, this is minus 8, 6 plus 2 is 8, minus 20 is minus 12. And when you do, when you multiply every element with minus 1 by 4, okay, you will get it as minus 1 by 4 into minus 4 is 1, minus 1 by 4 into minus 8 is 2, minus 1 by 4 into minus 12 is 3, 1, 2, 3. And we know that this variable matrix X is simply nothing but the matrix having the variables X, Y, Z. And if you equalize these two, X is equals to 1, Y is equals to 2, Z is equals to 3. and after having this x, y and z, you just check if it correct or not, just by replacing these values in the given equations. Now they are correct, right? So 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equals to 6, and 1, 2, 3, just taking the second equation. 2 into 1, 2, 3 into 6, 3 into 2, 6, 4 into 3, 12. 12 plus 6 plus 2, again it gives us 20. So these are the values of x, y, z, and this is the way of solving given system of linear equations in 3 variables using matrix inversion method. Okay, and then in the next point, in the sense in 46b, I am going to solve these equations using Cramer's method. Okay, just have a look. So the next thing is Cramer's method of solving. See, for the given system of equations, this is the matrix form, and it is of the format Ax is equals to b. We know that A is the coefficient matrix, X is the variable matrix, and B is the constant matrix. To solve the problem in Cramer's method, we need to find out determinants delta, delta 1, delta 2, and delta 3. See, as we discussed in the last class, there are just delta, delta 1, delta 2, because there the equations are two equations in two variables, so we have just delta 1 and delta 2. But here, since there are three variables, we need to find delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. So what is delta, what is delta 1, what is delta 2, and what is delta 3? As we mentioned in the 2 by 2 system, in the same way we need to extend it for 3 by 3. So delta is first, it is nothing but the determinant of this coefficient matrix. So the determinant of this 1, 1, 1, okay, 2, 3, 4, and then 1, 2, minus 1 is delta. And after that, coming to delta 1, for delta 1, as I mentioned you in the previous problem, see, you just rewrite this first column for delta 1, replace the first column with the constant matrix. So take here it is 6, 22. And then the remaining two columns as it is, you just take 1, 3, 2, 1, 4, minus 1. This is delta 1. Then whereas coming for delta 2, so since for delta 2, we need to replace the second column. Okay, the first column is 1, 2, 1. Second column is 622, and the third column is again 14 minus 1. And then coming to delta 3. For delta 3, for 3, you just replace this third column with the constant matrix, and the first two columns are same. Okay, 1, 2, 1, and then 1, 3, 2, and then the last one is 622. Okay, so we need to find these determinants. After finding these determinants, okay, in Cramer's method, as we discussed in the previous case, x is equals to delta 1 by delta. The formula for the x is delta 1 by delta. And the formula for the y is delta 2 by delta. And the formula for z is delta 3 by delta. You just find determinant values and use these three formulas, x, y and z. From there you will get the values of x, y and z. Okay, there ends the solution. So the determinant of this coefficient matrix, which is delta, as we found in matrix inversion method, this value is minus 4. And now we need to find the determinants of these three. Okay, just try to find all these three. So on finding the determinants, we will get that what? Delta 1 is equals to again minus 4, delta 2 is minus 8, and delta 3 as minus 12 we will get. And as per the rule, x is what? Delta 1 by delta. So minus 4 by minus 4, and that value is 1. So x is 1. And delta 2 by delta is y, which is minus 8 by minus 4. It gives us 2. Z is delta 3 by delta, minus 12 by minus 4, which is nothing but 3. So at the end, again, we have x, y, z values as 1, 2, 3. And again, if you need, just check them by replacing into the given equations. Already we did it in the matrix inversion method, then no need, okay? Just have a look. Solving the given system of linear equations in three variables using two different methods. One is the matrix inversion method and the other is the Cramer's method. For the matrix inversion method, we need to follow the rule that x is equals to what? A inverse B, okay? And whereas for the Cramer's method, we need to find the values of four determinants, delta, delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. And after having these deltas, you can find x by using delta 1 by delta, y by using delta 2 by delta, and z by using delta 3 by delta. Okay, and while constructing this delta 1, delta 2, delta 3, they are simply nothing but the matrices or determinants formed by the delta just by replacing first column for delta 1, second column for delta 2, and by replacing third column for delta 3. Okay, you need to memorize the procedure, how to solve the equations using inversion method and how to solve the equations using Cramer's method. Okay.